know why I don't sleep, but if you have a problem, you need to sit down, okay? We prefer that we are funny.
So welcome everyone. This is Social Dissonance. It's a durational concert. We are trying to interpret this score over there, but it's not so easy, so we need your help, your participation, and your suggestions. I have to inform you about some things. First of all, we're being filmed, as you can see, and this film is right now online, online streamed on Periscope, and it's going to be archived and projected tomorrow on this screen. What is more, we cannot use these doors as exits, but we can exit only from that door from now on. And we will ask you to stay for the whole hour of the concert, because it's very important for us and it's very crucial for a situation to be built. But if you want to live in the middle, of course you can. No, sorry. We can use only that door as an exit from now on. Yes, okay, yeah. Yeah, just to... in the middle of a concert, of course you can, but you will be asked to give some feedback before you go, in order for us to learn from your comments and improve what we're doing. Two more things. One is that we have to speak one by one so that we can all hear each other and try to speak loudly and clearly, and be a little bit careful with the curtains because they are a little bit fragile. Thank you.
There are many works that focus on the wrongs of this world. such as, let's say, the refugee crisis and various inequalities, discrimination against various groups, and so on. So I would like to ask you if we can all share what we think is wrong with this world. Maybe think of it as a way to explain to someone in the next documenta in 5 years what the world looked right now, like what are the wrongs of the world right now.
Yeah, because I forgot to mention that the video will be uploaded also on YouTube. Can speak to the audience of the next documenta, in a way.
I think what I saw till now, the problem is everybody talking, doing nothing. That I was a little bit, for me it was too much. And I think everybody talking is very chic, and it's good to be in YouTube to talk to the Facebook, and nobody do something. And probably in the city, but I saw the poor people in the street, but nobody watched them. And it's very good to go and see the artists. It's very in, it's very interesting. But something I think in the street, in the tramway, where the people, they sit in the banks. I think the work that I wanted to see, it was more than what I saw in the street, that what everybody screaming here. That what I felt, probably just because we're talking and we do nothing. That's why did I think. It's the same for me. It's not judging the other
maybe you can the question again.
The question was.
But okay, it's for the. What is what we saw on documenta? What we think is good or bad?
What we think is wrong with this world?
With this world, okay.
And we would explain this. Let's say referring to a future audience of documenta. Like, well, how would you explain to the audience that will come in 5 years what are the wrongs of this?
But in general, not dependent on what I see here.
No, no.
It's
in general.
What I see on TV or everything.
What do you consider to be the wrongs of this world?
I think there's very many. Yeah. Well, maybe I think a little bit more and that.
Yeah. I think a big
want to think very global and we want to look all over the world, but especially in Europe, many states are look nowadays on themselves, like Brexit or something. And I think this is a big problem, that we want to look global and think global, like the artists on this documenta, but the states and the the people, many people in the states are not not surprised over the situation nowadays and look then more on their self and not on the others, and so there's more voting for parties. They just want to serve the state the little states and not the global.
I think the whispering voices here in the documenta say it very good, and they say ignorance is a really good thing. So, yes, the people are ignorant. Yes.
The people are ignorant, but they tend to have much more access to information. Better information, but at least much bigger, quantity. So I don't think we are really ignorant anymore. And this is kind of a paradox, which for me is also a big problem nowadays, is that on one side we're much more aware of all the diversity in the world because we have much more access to differences, to faraway countries, and to all this diversity, and we're confronted to it every day. But on the other side, there is a tendency to homogenize everything, to unify everything in name of very Eurocentered, or let's say Occidental principles, like democracy and those very big abstractions which we want to enforce on all other people, folks, or whatever. So it's a tendency to be more aware of diversity and to save it and keep it, preserve it. But on the other side, this big abstraction that tends to more unity and to destroy differences and diversity.
Can we try to speak a little bit louder, because the audience online cannot hear?
I think the question in general is really difficult because it's such a big question, and that's why I think most of us don't know what to say, because there are so many problems, and it's like, where do we even start? Obviously we all here and we're interested in arts and the documenta, but also how you said, like, that people talk about it but don't do anything actually. And as I'm thinking, like, trying to pick like one big problem of the world, it's not that easy. It's like one problem leads to another one, and then there's so many problems. So I think it's quite a, not difficult, but it's a very big question. And we all have like different experiences and then different problems, so my problem might not be the same as the other ones. So I think it's, yeah, I don't know how to start with the problem because there are just like so many.
But
what aspect of the human being can combine all these bad things in our global system. So maybe there is some typical human characterized thing that makes us acting like we do, so that all these things happen that we're just talking, and maybe it's just like we're overwhelmed with all this quantity or mass of information, so we just have no other chance to focus on something, and the result is that we just lose the contact to other things. So we start keeping in our private circle and in our confidential circle, just to be sure that even in this room we can possibly do something right, but it's impossible for us to change something global. So maybe it's just like it's too much for us, for our being as a human being. And by the try to get rid of all these problems, we just produce more of them. So by trying to ignore some things to get focused on other things which we think are more important, these things become worse, and so there's just like a circle of things that become worse and worse. Maybe it's a circle of, or a line of problems we just can't get out of just because of our type of being.
I even think that it's part of humanity to have problems like that. It's not worse today than it was 20 years ago or 1,000 years ago. Or it's always, and of course, every human being tries to be a good guy, tries to have family, to be happy. But I don't really think that it's so, it's worse than it was. Or in 5 years, the next documentary, it will be the same. And the expectation that we could solve problems in the world, I don't think so. We can't. And it's not the expectation somebody has to me, because my expectation is to be honest with my family and to be a good guy. And that's enough, that's already difficult enough. And that's what I think in the documentary, when I see this boat and people and the problems of the world come here, yes, it doesn't mean so much to me to see this, to try really to get all the problems of the world in this documentary. It's I don't think it's so necessary.
But that doesn't make possible to get all of the problems of the world to the documentary.
No.
And I understand when you say trying to be a good guy, and like as a person do what we can as best as we can and be conscious. And it's like, but at the same time, it's like beating yourself up because in Germany or in Europe, most people they're well off, and then trying to make yourself feel bad because other people are not is also, I think, difficult, because we don't choose to be born in a certain country, and I think it's really difficult. It's like a fine line of like trying to change something, but at the same time, like not really knowing how, and then thinking it's not enough, but then at the same time thinking it is enough to be just as good as you can be. I don't know. I think it's really complex.
I think what you're talking, it's about, I start first with myself, that what I understood. That means I try to be a good guy, to be nice with my family, and I understand that. I think everybody try, I hope. But one way it's look like you say, I want to have my house very nice, but it's burning around. How you can, I think how you are, it's, that means how I am with the other people around me. But what is the first is your family, and after your friends, and after the society. When inside of the society doesn't work, how you can to do it? You know, it's also my question. That means I cannot, I try to be a good girl, to be good with my friends, with my couple, or I don't know. But when something is wrong around me, it's very short with my neighbor. What I can do it, it's we cannot just say, I try to be bad and I don't want to see what's happening around. Or I cannot do, or it's a part of the humanity to be there. I understand also, because if you want to see the light, you should have the shadow. It will be all of that. But I think now it's a little bit shadow is too big. That is coming too much. And I think every time in the past, there is a time it's too dark, and after something has happened. And now it's probably it's a transition, within changing. It's something's happened. Why there is all of this question here? That is something, yes. It's all is also my question.
Humans repeat themselves over thousands of years. Things, it's like, yeah, come and go, and like waves, and a little bit like you said, maybe we're just in a time of between, we're maybe now down here or up there, but there's always a time to where you have the choice. And for example, we have the choice to vote in Germany. This is something very, this is not only concerning my family, this is something for the society. And so I would say there's always the chance to decide whether this or that. So this is very important for me that people take this choice, take this chance for choosing and to express themselves. Yeah, that's something that's what is really actual now. And what happened in the last 2 years, like Brexit or, for example, or the elections in the US or in France, people had the choice. And so maybe this is very special for our days, that people realize we have the choice and they watch things happen there because people choose that, and we decide no, we don't want that, so we take another choice. So go and vote.
Sometimes even you have the choice. The government could be could do a how can I say a coup of state?
Sorry?
Yes, a coup of state, like a sorry, I'm from Brazil. Yeah, I'm from Brazil, and now we are having a president that is not the president that we choose. You know, the president Dilma, she was elected by millions of Brazilian people, and then the government made this, you know, a dirty thing, and take her out, and what can you do now? Because this guy and the other in the government now, they are choosing laws that cut the direct, how can I say, the cutting the freedom, the rights of the labor, you know, people that think that stop working in certain age now don't have such perspective. So sometimes we don't have these shoes that we say yes. And for me, it's really a chance to be here. But seeing that we are all white people here, we don't have any black people, you see, it's comfort for you and for me. For me, a little bit less, because I'm a woman and it's not safe. Sometimes, anytime, when you think your body is exposed, for example, I'm traveling alone here, and sometimes I don't know if I have to know, take the right street at night, for example, but we are all white and we all have the condition to be here. And I think this talks about another condition that we don't see in our comfortable space. I don't know if I can. Yeah, sorry. It's difficult to me to speak in English, but I'm trying to. Yes.
I mean, coming back to what you said about democracy, I would like to add, like, for example, I come from Greece. We elected a certain government because we wanted to oppose European measures, and he was elected. He made a referendum. They made a referendum, and then they made a certain series of choices for which not all the Greek people agree with, and at the same time we cannot agree or we cannot influence the choices of the European Union. So how can we say that voting gives us so much power if we cannot decide, for example, for the choices of Germany and other nations that we are related to and have direct impact on our lives.
I didn't understand. How can we vote?
Like, we can vote, we can ensure that the person that we voted for, the party that we voted for, is in power. But this doesn't mean that we have power over their choices, and this doesn't mean that we have power over other people that influence those choices.
Of course not. How is it possible? It can't be possible.
That's the risk. That's the risk.
But it's not possible. Yeah. How could you, if you, I vote somebody, but I can't know that he will do everything I want him to do, because...
Okay, it's not about that. I think that the thing that is interesting in the Greek thing is that, as you said before, we also voted in the referendum and we voted no to these measures. But then we had imposed these measures. So this is as an answer to the previous person. Sorry, I don't know your name. To you, as an answer to you, yeah, because we also chose, but it didn't have any effect.
But I think it's a risk, of course, to vote, but it's, for me, it's not the choice to not vote, you know, because this is the first step out of democracy. And so I prefer to take a risk. Yeah, and do not stop taking this chance, and maybe, yeah.
But the democracy or to vote is not the answer for the problems
in the world.
In
not
the world.
Of course, but it's
not in the, maybe not.
It's because you mentioned it actually.
that's a problem now in Germany. We have the choice between Merkel and Scholz, and they are similar. So they have no difference, I think.
But
so it's yeah.
But because that's what the people want. They want Merkel or Scholz, or they don't want change.
Because that's
people
the comfort.
Don't want it.
But why?
Why? But people like their life in Germany.
Yes,
for example.
The life is good. We have a good life, but it's too. Yes, I don't know.
But maybe they're surprised over the votes, but there's coming through. Maybe the people won't change. We don't know now.
Yeah.
I hope so.
Yes.
Yes, of course.
In which direction? The AfD with 25%.
Oh, no.
But that's the only chance we have that for changes that we get AfD and some right wing.
No,
no,
no.
Chance
no.
that they have others to.
No, but that it will not happen. But I think it will not. It's not no surprise for that. It's not no. Yeah, it's
but
it's hope.
So
hope.
Nobody.
It's
hope,
yeah.
It's a tragedy that the AfD are so supported in Germany. I think it's the horrible way it can go. So I hope it goes another way.
But maybe then we can just sum it up to the global problem that there seems something not to work, and that maybe all these different groups are just caused because there's not enough group identification or love or respect. So maybe these are the things we are really trying to get and to find, but no one is ready to give another person, a whole stranger, all this love I can give to my friend or my family. So maybe there's a disbalance between who we love, who we respect as a person next to me, who has the same rights, who I want him to have a lucky life or have chances as I have in Germany. So maybe there's not the political problems, isn't the thing which isn't working in Germany or in the global system. So maybe this is happening in every country, I think. So America, France, Turkey,
Russia.
So there, this thing is repeating the whole time, so everyone is looking for change and tries to change something, and so it's better to take a risk than to stuck in this system and hoping someday maybe it will go to a nice end. But maybe there's just this position we take ourselves in position to other people.
I think that's what I wanted to say, that we don't have to have the expectation, for example, for politics, that they will make the change or the party people will change. It changed, in my opinion, it changed already to the good for the last 5,000 years. I prefer to live today than to live in 1943 in Germany, or to live in the 80s, or to live, I don't know. In all the time there were very difficult situations, and we cannot have the expectation that politics will change something. They just organize the daily life problem, but we can change ourselves to be more respectful to the children, everybody.
What if you cannot go out to your country? Is this something you can change by yourself?
If I cannot go out from the country?
Yes. Like if you cannot have a passport, if the state doesn't give you a passport, then how exactly can you make that better, if not changing politics?
That's a very difficult question to me, because I can't go out of my country. I don't live this experience.
Yes, you are saying that, of course, politics affect the way we live our everyday life, but they also affect very crucial decisions we may make. For example, if you live in a state that does not allow you to go out of the country, then it is not just your everyday life.
No, but in the GDR, for example, they couldn't go out from the country, so they decided to go to Prague and to Budapest, and to so many of them didn't want to not to stay in the country, they wanted to travel, so they just did it. Took their children, and they changed a system and changed Europe and the world, but not by being politic, but just by little steps.
Isn't that a very good decision?
Not conceptual political. It's the way of, I don't want to live here anymore, I go somewhere else.
Yes, but some people have no choice or have no chance to leave their country. And this is, I think this is the ignorance from the European people. I'm so happy that I live here. I'm happy that I don't live in Russia or in the Arabic countries, but I don't live there. I have to see the problems from the people who have to live in these countries.
Of course, you have to, I was in White Russia. People, it's difficult life there, but it's my concept. If I tell them you have to be democratic, you have to be this and this and this, from my German point of view, it doesn't work. And they don't want it, the people I met. They think it's different. They have to do it by themselves. They have to develop it.
What you mean is not that it's not the German politicians, for example, can't go and say to the white Russian people,
yeah,
you have to choose this or that, or I try to understand what you mean.
Yes.
Mean that it has to come from themselves, the idea of how they want to live and to find the way how to realize.
But anyway, the question was, what are the world problems, not the Germany's problems?
But
now we would like to make another question, and because we are supposedly speaking to the future people in 5 years, so we would like also to tell them how we would like the world to be in 5 years.
Maybe just one community.
I hope there will be a new president in the U.S.
I think what you're telling is a little bit utopian.
Mm-hmm.
And probably, I'm sure it will not happen, but just thinking this utopia could be.
This is what we're thinking now, the utopia.
Yeah, I think it's just utopia.
You
yeah.
can call it an ideal, but I think even having an ideal or an utopian
mm-hmm.
idea, so maybe this is something you can try to reach, and even this try to reach it can make it better, maybe. So as we said at the beginning, there won't be any situation where there aren't any problems in this world, but maybe we can just like spare an energy to feel confident with the way we are going and with the aims we are trying to reach.
And realistically, how we can imagine the world in 5 years?
For example, I think, just as an example, I hope there won't be any people who tell others that the change of the climate is a lie. and that people find it normal to start thinking ecological in their private lives, and that they really can start in their very personal life supporting the climate in a positive way. So this is something the whole world should like could practice wherever you live, and that we are encouraged to leave our comfort zone to go that step, and to that people find it normal. When I was a child, nobody had the rubbish was not like in about 30 years ago, nobody would have collect different rubbish. So that's very normal for children today. So I think you can change things in a little, and that's something I hope in 5 years we will be a step more, that everybody is able to not take the car or do whatever. Well, you know what I mean.
I hope that in 5 years we can go to Damascus and be there to a concert or something, that it's Syria is again a functional country.
Peaceful
country.
No violence.
With women. That women can go to anywhere, expose her bodies like they want to. No rapes.
Not have to worry about, okay, how should I dress?
Yes.
I have to think about other people, how they're gonna react, and not that, and just do what feels right.
No violence with women. Yes.
Not realistic
in
5 years.
Yeah, but
you're dreaming of. I would like to
see. We are fighting, aren't we? So, yes.
Maybe that here in this room in 5 years can stand any type of guy or woman or color. So maybe then they will meet here again.
And I hope that people in, I don't know the English name, North Korea,
mm-hmm.
Yes, make a revolution.
Yes.
That would be great.
I hope different communities could find a way to be self-sustainable and in solidarity with other communities.
And I have to say, for a thing that it's the present now in the old politics that are in the government in Brazil, because it's really difficult now for people. And I know it's just not for us, but for other countries, but it's like for a thing.
And if we make this shift to the realism, do you think the answers would have been different? If we say how realistically is going to be in 5 years, do you think the answers will be different?
just want to know if it's realistic what we were, our utopia.
Yeah, if we shift from the utopian to the realism, what we actually believe it will happen in 5 years, would the answers would be different?
In part of the world it will change. In Syria, I'm really optimistic that it will change. For women, I have a feeling they will have a fight, will turn longer, really, to be peaceful with every color and everybody. In 50 years, 500 years, it will be a wonderful world.
Maybe. Do you say the opposite?
No.
Okay.
I don't know.
Okay,
but
can
we don't know what happens.
Yeah.
I think the economic crisis will be ongoing.
For sure.
And maybe the war in Syria will not, but it will be somewhere else.
Yeah.
I want to say something about the money.
Mm-hmm.
I hope that the everyone wants, or maybe not everyone, but many people want to have money or have nice things. Yeah, I hope there will be a change, maybe
like
in
universal,
5 years or
like
more
universal
years.
Basic income. Like universal basic income.
Grundeinkommen.
Yeah. For example. Yeah. Or that there are more people. Not only in Germany, all over the world. They don't have to think how they should do their day, their normal daily life. It should be easier for them. Don't know how we can do that, but can hope.
But it's again something of expectation, I think. Because, for example, to have a bread, butter, and tomato. I guess 500 years ago, you had to work for that 8 hours a day. To have that today, even if you get only €8.50 Mindesteinkommen, you maybe have to work 1 hour. So it already changed to a better.
It doesn't happen in all the world.
Yeah.
I think it's probably happened in Germany, in Europe, or some countries in France. I don't know. But why it's happening like that? Why now you should not work for 8 hours? This 7 hours, okay for that? I think that the other countries for that also. You cannot just say, now we have this value, we have your economy. Probably we should change our values, our economy. And that is, I think, I hope, that is, sure, now we are living very good in Europe, but why?
But
where is coming? That is, that means this all of the world that didn't change. That is.
But in China, for example, the first period, they had no hunger crisis, where 1 million people died a year. The first years, for the last 2,000 years, were the last 15 years. 2,000 years, every year, a lot of people died for hunger in China. Now they are 1 billion and 1,7 Milliarden Leute. Not a lot of people, and everybody gets enough food. It's something changed. It's a lot of problems. They have problems, of course, but they don't die for not having food.
Yes.
It's development.
Sure.
In India,
where they are. They are going to the Africa. Also the Chinese, you can find it in Africa.
Yeah, but
that they took the farmers, you know, it's all together. You cannot, it's sure, there is technology, it's
yes.
very good. The human being is very intelligent. But how we use it, that is a problem. Probably we should change values, how we are doing. That is.
Yes.
And I think nowadays maybe the Chinese have enough food, but for which price? It's a big climatic price, I think, that we pay with this food in China. There's a big climatic problem in China and a global, of course. And so the food comes not from the sky or so. So there's a price we pay for this, I think.
Yeah, but I think we have we will have the technology. We don't verteilen. Was it verteilen?
Share.
We don't share it well. But there's not enough food for everybody. We have.
Yeah.
We
yeah.
just share. Don't
yeah.
share it. We don't have the system now to.
Or we put it into gas. This benzene.
The food.
Yeah,
yeah, we have so much that we can even make it to gas. We have too much food.
Yes.
We sell our food to Africa. We have too much.
What is interesting to me is how the conversation is so focused on our position in this universal thing that we try to discuss. And also at first, when we asked about the problems of the world, there were many people that talked about our position to the problems of the world, or our privileged position, or how we feel about this, or if we should guilty or not feel guilty, or do something or not do something, or talk or act, or I don't know. But I understand it from the one hand, but on the other hand, it is very interesting to me how we asked something about the whole world problems, and it turned to be so focused on our position, our personal, very personal position to that. And this is about the concert, because we have done it a lot of times. I think that maybe in the first days maybe we would point it more this. Do you understand? Yeah.
I didn't understand.
Yeah,
in the first days of the documenta you did what?
Yes. I think it is a comment about our concert, that because we have done it a lot of times, and I think that if this happened like the first days that we have done this concert, we would point it, and now we didn't in a way. Or this is my thoughts. Sorry.
But doesn't it happen automatically? I mean, the frame of the performance or the concert, or it's already a filter. No, the documenta is already a filter with the price, with the concept. And you meet people that are basically interested in art, they can afford it. And as you said, there is no diversity in this group. And when you ask this very, very vague and general question of what are the wrongs in the world, automatically we think from our perspective, because it's just not
of course,
possible.
From which perspective could you see that?
Yeah,
yeah, I'm not saying that I expected something else. It's just an observation I make. It's not that something wrong, or I just found it interesting personally.
Yeah, because it's difficult to talk about a situation that is not
yours.
For example, a prejudice of to be an immigrant, for example, a refugee. I don't feel that, but I know that is a problem that we see in a lot of works here, and it touches me, of course. But I don't feel comfortable to talk about it because, you know, it's not a subject that I, suffer, for example. But not, I'm not, you know, it touched me, of course.
I agree that, of course, we always see the world from our own eyes and from our own perspective, and maybe doing something different would create a non-representative image of what the world is, because we cannot be in all parts of the world at the same time. And I think our comments today were very representative of our own lives. So to a future audience, I think this would be very helpful to see, for example, what, I don't know, the average Northern or even Northern European person who goes to an art exhibition thinks like. And I also, I have a lot of doubts and many thoughts about discussing problems that are not your own, like many artists are trying to do, like talking about the refugee crisis or hunger in Africa or other such matters. I find that sometimes it becomes very problematic when you try to speak about problems that you have not experienced and cannot have full access to.
I agree with someone that said that he wants to become a little bit better. I always thought that for me, maybe I'm too cynical and I cannot do anything about all that. And the only thing I want is to become a little bit better for my father. If I do that, I already feel I've done what I can for. I don't know what I can do for the rest of the world. I mean, don't see. Some of us maybe feel also like this, that we're too small to. That's it.
Just adding on to what you said, I think, especially artists, or when they're showing their work, for example, at the Documenta, and they're trying to tell or show people how it is, like a refugee or something, I don't think they should do it from that perspective when they don't know enough or when they haven't experienced it, because I think that's just fake and you shouldn't talk about things you don't know, and I think that generates like misunderstandings. And adding on to what you said, I think it's just personally for me important to know, be aware of the problems and do your best as you can and try to be respectful and try to be better. And through that you can generate change through people that are around you, and then it's like a chain connection that keeps on going.